So a situation has been brought to my attention, and as usual, tending to be the last person on this stuff, I'm finally getting to talk about it here. So, by the time this goes out, time is relative, but a few days ago for me, as of me recording this, a situation occurred that gave me an opportunity to bring this topic up again. I've sort of touched on this before, but I feel this is a perfect example of what I'm talking about. Now, maybe not necessarily perfect because there are some definite problems with this individual we're going to talk about. And I want to say right now, before we talk about this situation, just so you know, I'm not trying to hate on this person or anything like that. I'm actually a fan of the channel we're going to be talking about today. I watched his content for a little bit before it got taken down, but unfortunately, it's almost kind of comical. I had just subscribed to him like maybe a week or two ago, and then his whole channel got shut down. Sorry, fidgeting. I do that. So that happened, and that the person we're talking about and the situation we are talking about is the bearing situation. Now, for those who don't know about this situation, because bearing, he was big and number wise he was pretty big, but compared to some of the other bigger YouTubers out there, he was about mid-range, I'd say. He had about maybe 350K subscribers, something like that. So he was a pretty big channel, but not wave sending bait, if you know what I mean. But anyway, I digress. His channel recently had been terminated, and the reason it had been terminated, we didn't know at the time. So when we had heard, first of all, I would like to apologize for anyone who follows me on Twitter because I sort of jumped the gun myself, being a fan. I assumed that because a lot of people were assuming and saying, and what happened was that he had been censored, and this immediately freaked me out because of past experiences with YouTube, I had thought, "Oh fuck, this is the purge." Because what happened was, and let me give you a little context: a lot of YouTubers had been wiped in this day, like many YouTubers. A guy named Edgy Sphinx, Bearing as well. A bunch of people had been wiped just out off the map, just wiped off the entire platform. Just virtually out of nowhere. No one expected it. I don't watch Edgy's content, and there's a few more that were banned, but I don't have a list of names or anything. It's just those are the primary two I had personally heard about. Now, of course, when this happened, as I said, because of previous and prior experiences myself, I was freaking out. So I started immediately signing a petition, like because there was a petition going around to try and bring it back. I was trying to, I was basically in, oh fuck, they're trying to censor us mode. I need to fucking defend myself and defend the community kind of thing. I was in that mode, and because of that, I didn't. I because of that, I jumped to conclusions, and then it came to light. The information came to light that changed the story entirely. So much so that it's arguable that Bearing was taken down, potentially in potentially not in mistake, potentially correctly taken down. Now, again, I don't say that with malice, and I don't say that with joy. I was legitimately a fan of Baron, and I'm not happy it happened either. But regardless, it happened, and if we're sticking with the truth, and we are on this channel, and I tend to always, we must honestly admit to ourselves that when it comes to copyright, it's Baron. It looked like Baron was in the wrong, and we're gonna get into that in a moment. Well, by a moment, I mean like right now. So, brilliant, I know. Bearing, I would show you his avatar, the avatar in question that got him banned. But the problem is, if I do that, I could be at risk of takedown myself. So, unfortunately, I can't do that. I might be able to link something. I don't know. We'll see in post what I can do. But he had used a bear, bearing kind of in the name. He had used a bear as his avatar, and for the longest time he had used it. And he did all these things with it. And turns out, unbeknownst to me, even though I was a fan of this show, it was actually a bear from a show called Total Drama Island, but made by, I believe, their name Fresh TV or just Fresh, one of those. And of course, this means that Bearing legitimately did take something from another work, and he didn't he didn't just use it in fair use. Like, it's one thing to use a clip and then use it in fair use later a little bit. This was different. He used it as his avatar and he used it as his persona. This is where, legality-wise, he was completely in the wrong, and frankly, this is a pretty clear-cut case in a lot of issues. Obviously, he was in the wrong, and the company technically, rightfully, took him down. However, we'll get into why I think it's technically wrong what they did and how they went about it, but that's my opinion, obviously, but we'll get into that in a moment. But, so, when the company found this, they took it down. Information continued to come to light, and it was just a mess. A lot of things had happened, and 2 days later, he's still banned. I don't think he's coming back. He's going to come back to YouTube. Rumor is, anyway, that he's going to come back to YouTube, but they're like fan sourcing a new bear to use. So make of that what you will. I think that's kind of a cool thing, to be honest. A community-made avatar. I think that's really cool, honestly. But he should have done that from the beginning, to be honest. Obviously, he couldn't because he had no audience. And that's where, as a creator myself, I'm like, that sucks, you know, because as creators, we only have what resources we're given, like, and what friends and circles we have and what resources and whatnot. We can't do everything, especially when we're first starting out, and I definitely know what that's like. But regardless, he shouldn't have done it. He just shouldn't, because now he's gotten hit. And even if he was going to do it, he should have fixed it by now. He's been using this from the beginning, apparently, and he never did. So he was completely in the wrong for that, and honestly, he was arguably rightfully taken out. And frankly, in the matter of truth, I think, yeah, he was, because it's a pretty clear-cut case. Now, the thing that I want to say, though, in his defense, is how this... Oh, God, I'm sorry. Fucking dropping shit. Now, this is where I want to come to his defense, and I want to talk about automation in YouTube. What I mean by that is these programs that, or whatever you want to call them, software, whatever they use. Frankly, I don't even know the technology they use, but these things that people can use, copyright people, copyright holders, whatever, to essentially find videos almost instantaneously, and then without even a word, take them down without anything. Just take them the fuck down without anything, frankly, at all. Not so much as a single letter of exchange. Just down, out, you're done, channel dead. That's what I want to talk about. And the reason I want to talk about that is, in Baron's defense, I think the company handled this wrong. What I mean by that is, oh yes, one thing we have to get into, though, before I say this. Baron also, and this is where... And I'm going to bring this up as an example, too. And even in his defense, for example, he also used this avatar to sell merchandise. So that's a definite ouchie. But from my understanding, and this is where things get interesting about this case, and this is why I think that, frankly, this is a matter of a problem on YouTube, not really a clear-cut copyright type thing. The merchandise, when his channel was removed, I believe it might even still be up. He's still selling the merchandise. I don't know. As of me recording this, I don't know. I did check, and I think it was still up. But as of me putting this video out, it could be down. Who knows? But this is what's interesting about that, though. His channel was taken down. A minor, quote-unquote, offense. Not really a minor, but, you know, it wasn't as big because he was just using it as his avatar. A minor offense, he got shut down instantaneously in almost pitch-perfect exactness that almost seems unhuman. So, my assumption being it was a program of some kind, software, something like that. Meanwhile, the merchandise was still up, and it was for quite some time. And that's because YouTube has an interesting system where, as I said, it's very automated. There's very little human interaction. They give arguably way too much, and I personally think they do give too much power to copyright holders. Instead of you doing the traditional method of either having to file a legitimate takedown notice Because sometimes they do. It's arguable that, yes, they do. But it's a YouTube version, so sometimes it's a little weird how that works. But they use that. And then they have these programs as well, Content ID, that lets you find it instantly. So you can just copy-paste everything and remove it all almost instantaneously. But you can't do that elsewhere. And that's why I think, personally, it's a problem here. Because, you see, when YouTube does this, they encourage a kind of shoot first, ask questions later mentality. What I mean by that is, look what they did with Barry. While, yes, you can argue that what he did was wrong, and it was, if in my opinion, at least, and honestly, the majority of people seem to think that is the case. He was wrong, if we are speaking bluntly and honestly. While he was in the wrong, I personally feel, and I think I'm sure someone in the world probably knows where I'm coming from when I say this, because I've seen it around a little bit, even prior, before I had decided to make this a topic, that really, if this was anywhere else, a cease and desist letter, a email, strongly worded email, something would have been sent rather than just a boom, overnight. Because Barry went from clean slate to dead channel in essentially a day, not even a day, hours. Because the way he described it in his own personal account was that he was minding his own business. He's working on videos. One minute he looked at the channel, and then he went back. Like an hour later, he comes back. The channel's dead. So that's awful, too. Losing your channel. Holy fuck. When I lost my channel because of that crazy fucking flag, and then I had to get it back. Oh, my God. I was... Yeah. Regardless, in this case, as I said, Baring was in the wrong. But this is the kind of thing that I think is the problem, and what just leaves a very sour taste in my mouth. Shut up. That didn't sound wrong at all. Shut up. Stop it. Anyway. They didn't have to take his channel down. What they could have done is just simply... Now, see, they might have freaked out because of the merchandise, but if they freaked out because of the merchandise, I hear someone saying, then why didn't they take the merchandise down first? The merchandise is still up, or potentially is still up. By the time this goes up, it might be down. But it was still up, as if his channel being taken down. So, what's that about? I can't answer that, if it's as clear-cut as they say. And it's even more murky, and we'll get into that in a minute. But they didn't have to instantly take him down. They could have easily reached out to him and asked him to take it down nicely. And this could have all been resolved much more peacefully. Now, were they in the right to do it? Yes, I'm not arguing they are not in the right to do it. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is it makes them look bad. Even when people defend their actions like I am, like I said, they were in the right to do it. Even when people defend their actions, it still leaves a very sour taste in many people's mouths when they just, rather than speaking to him, just took him down without a word. Now, again, like I said, it's totally their right. And just for the sake of not repeating myself, let's move on here. So that happened. His channel was taken down. And once the news came out that it was as clear-cut as that was, that was it. Case looked pretty settled. And while I didn't like it, it is what it was. And I expected... Many of us had signed a petition. I believe it's now at 33,000 signatures. But we didn't expect it to go anywhere. However, then this is where the story changes. Barry's channel came back. Don't get your hopes up, though. We gotta continue. Sorry if you heard that bang. His channel came back. And everything looked good. Everything looked fine. He had begun to privatize all the videos. So he was going to, from what I understand, he said, by that I mean he literally has friends with pretty big subscriber bases, and he asked them to put a video on their channels, and they did, in a heartbeat, pretty much. But what happened was, his channel came back. All his videos were gone, of course, because he had privatized them all. For those of you who don't know, we YouTubers don't tend to delete videos. We tend to, unless for whatever reason we don't want to make the money, we don't tend to delete videos. We tend to privatize them. So to you guys, it looks like we delete them. And sometimes slang term is we, quote-unquote, delete them. But we actually keep them so we can, you know, keep the money. Now, like I said, if, for example, in my case, I don't know about other people, but in my case, if I had accidentally monetized the video and I didn't want to make money off it, I'd probably delete it and re-upload just so I didn't get that money. Because from my understanding, when you delete the video, all revenue gets killed. And the money just goes straight to YouTube. So, but I digress. So his channel came back, and his videos were privated, and he was working on fits and everything. Everything looked, okay, cool, the company's awesome. See, that's where the sour taste went away. I was like, okay, cool, see, they can work it out like reasonable adults. And then I had made a Twitter twit longer, basically saying, I was going to talk about this week and say, see, this is what the problem is with automation. It makes things too easy. People jump the gun, but look at this. They worked it out like reasonable adults, and there you go. And then the story changed again. So glad, so fucking glad that I am slow when it comes to this stuff. They took his channel down again. From my understanding, it was them again too, because his channel still doesn't back up. And this is where I'm just goddamn baffled, frankly. This is where I get completely... Honestly, this is where I start to say, okay, this company is not, something ain't right here. Because, while they are in their right to do it, again, technically, by reinstating his channel, they essentially lied. Because they banned the channel, they took it down, they took it the fuck down, and that was that. So clearly, something had happened, and then they took it down again. Why? If there was an agreement, or if for whatever reason he disputed it, or they talked it out, which is my assumption, then why did they take it down again? This is where the questioner, I don't want to use skeptic, because that's a community, and I have nothing against them, personally. I watch many people who are, like, quote-unquote, leaders of that community, but I don't personally see myself as a skeptic, because, I don't know, even though I kind of had some of their attitudes, I just don't like to, I don't really like to associate myself with any movements, frankly, at all, really, but I digress. It's not really a movement, a community, but you know what I mean. I just like to be my own community, if you know what I mean, and then I just talk to other people. But anyway, so that happened, and the skeptic in me is like, wait a minute. So, they took him down. Everyone said, that's it, place cut. But then he comes back. And then we're like, oh yeah, he's back. And then they take him down again. Why would they do that if they had retracted their claim the first time? It makes absolutely no sense. And this is where I think, from a legal standpoint, something could actually be wrong here. In Baring's defense, and this is why I said this is where the defense comes in for Baring. Something doesn't seem right about this at all. Something doesn't smell right either. And the reason I say that is, while obviously it's very conspiracy-esque to say this, there was a very big uproar in a certain community we hate. Social justice warriors. A very big uproar in a certain community we hate that... many of them going after Baring, laughing at him, straight up attacking his Twitter, essentially, with, okay, strong words, you know what I mean. Just going at him on Twitter for losing his channel. Frankly, I'm surprised he was as calm as he did, even though he did tell a few people to go fuck themselves and said the cunt word quite a few times. That to me, that's mild. If someone had said that to me had I lost my channel... Ooh, anyway, but there was a very big uproar about this, and there was a conspiracy theory, because that's, I don't want to say that as a, like how the media these days does it, like they say, oh, that's just a conspiracy theory. I don't mean like that, it's just that's basically what it is. It is a theory. It's, fine, I'll call it a theory, how about that? I'm not trying to downgrade you or anything, but anyway. A theory had been around that perhaps it was a quote-unquote feminist or a SJW who had brought it to the company's attention and therefore had then demanded, because of outrage, say, I don't know, for example, How dare you allow this terrible, terrible human being to use this avatar to do this and da-da-da-da-da. And seeing how they had a legitimate case, they did take it down. The company, being nice, decided to bring him back. This is just my theory, personal theory now. The company brought him back. And because the outrage was still strong from the crazies, because it was so strong, they did it again. Because they wanted to save face, and they didn't want to look like, unfortunately, many businesses do this, they give in to social justice. So, I think, that's my personal theory on what happened. Obviously, only Barry's going to know. Even he might not know, because of how crap YouTube's communications can be when it comes to this shit. But, that's what I think happened. But, it still is very... If that was really the case, obviously the company was in their right to do it. But, that makes this a very different situation, because the company had originally removed the claim, which means originally their first thought was, okay, we can work out a deal. Instead, something changed their mind, whatever that something may be. Whether it be the SJW feminist, feminazi, whatever the fuck you want to call them. We don't know. At this point, this is where my knowledge of the story ends, because this story is still fresh and raw, and for all I know, things could change. I'm probably not going to be the last video on this, and because of that, somebody else might just say something that I won't. But this is where this is why I want to try and bring this into the topic that we're, you know, the title here. This is why I believe automation in YouTube is a problem. My assumption is that they used automated tactics because, as I said, YouTube is very, very much leaning in the direction of the copyright holder, which isn't a bad thing, because that's one thing I do have to definitely say. As a story writer, I'm kind of conflicted about this too, because if someone had been using one of my characters for any of this kind of crap that Baron was, well, I would want to do something. I would definitely want him to stop, frankly. But, that's why I want to try and bring this into this, that, as I've said in the past, we've had situations where copyright claims, personally, I've fought every single one of them because all my videos fall under fair use. I'm not in a situation like Baring. I am not using other people's work to do whatever the fuck with my own. I am using everything under fair use. I'm using clips, etc., etc., etc. Rarely am I using full videos, and if I ever do use a full video, it's a full video of a clip. I don't even do reaction type videos, though I have no problem doing it if somebody in the future wants me to do one, aka someone demands I do one by bringing my name up in a video. But this is why I want to talk about automation in YouTube a little bit. And we've kind of have for this entire thing. I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory. It's a problem. It encourages this very, very, very dangerous shoot first, ask questions later mentality, and it's killed many creators in the process, and it will continue to kill creators in the process. And unfortunately, unlike Baring, a lot of these creators, they don't get a second chance, because that's it. A lot of these creators don't have a major audience. Like, for example, if I was taken out now, it could be it for me. I could try and come back, and I have ideas if it ever happens, but it would still be much harder on me than it would be on Baring. Because of this situation, Baring, well, I lost his channel. He'll probably gain a lot of his subs back relatively quickly. So, Baring's in a much better situation than most. And especially because he had so much support from all his big subscriber buddies. Sargon of the Cut, Undoomed, I think Amazing Atheist too. A bunch of big people. So, I'm pretty sure he's going to get his subscribers back. But many of these people can't, and this is why I've always talked about this a little bit. I've gone into it, but this is why I think automation needs to just disappear from YouTube. Automation, programs, things that are automatic, should have nothing to do with complex situations like copyright copyright law or creative fields, period. And that's because, simply put, software and programs they're not complex enough to deal with the situation. They're just not. It's one thing to detect a thing. It's another to outright do everything for you, almost. Because when we do this, like I said, many creators are dying. And on top of that, this happens in no other real medium, really. It really doesn't. It doesn't happen on any other platform, any other medium. If this was, for example, let's use the CSGO situation as an example. When Valve decided that, we're going to use our copyright stuff to say no more of this shit, no more to the CSGO and all those gambling sites, they didn't have the option to just take down the sites. They had to send a cease and desist letter, which is why I brought it up earlier. There are ways to file DMCA outside of YouTube for websites and things like that, but it's not as easy as like it is on YouTube. And that's why I think it's a problem. Because when we give people the tools to do this, they will be abused. And that's the problem. It is convenient for companies to have these tools, but in complex situations like creativity and copyright, I would argue that this is not the kind of tools we should have. It should be entirely based... I'm losing my voice, I'm sorry. It should be entirely based on human interaction, human decision-making, human everything, everything human, because no program is complex enough to deal with things like this. It's just not. You don't know what the company thinks. It's the program will just do what it's programmed to do. Programs program the sense or anything with a certain word, it does it indiscriminately, regardless. And we've seen this with some of YouTube videos being taken down directly from YouTube itself by its own algorithms. It's happened, believe it or not. And everyone laughed, but the reality is that in itself should be proof that the system needs to change. Yet, for some reason, no one wants to do it. To be fair, many people have brought it up, I'm sure. Not, in my opinion, not as much as it should be brought up. Personally, I think this is a very, very big deal. And when everyone was freaking out about YouTube Heroes and all this stuff, what we really should have done is freaked out at the same level when, frankly, this even became a thing. Because this is very dangerous, and it's always been dangerous, and yet it's happened for years. And very few people stand up against it. I many times have been hit by these things falsely. I don't talk about it much. I talk about it vaguely on the channel. I don't talk about specific cases unless it's severe. But I've been hit by many of these. I take them, I send them all, I dispute them all. If they ever decline my dispute, I immediately fucking sign my real name and shit to the letter. Meaning that if they continue to do it, if they want the video down still, they have to take me to court. They have to do a DMCA. They have to do many, 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 many things. That I like about YouTube system. What I don't like is how easy it is for a company to just go, your video's gone. In the first place. I wish there was more communication. And frankly, I think there really needs to be more communication. There needs to be humans dealing with it. And even human-on-human interaction is not perfect. And that's the problem. There is no real easy way out of this situation. Because while this company did it legitimately, and they were in their right, there are many companies that do these things illegitimately and use money and power to remove people from this website in legitimate cases of censorship. It's happened many times. If you don't believe me, what's a good example? I believe the Daily Show? It might be called The Daily Show. Whatever that show is that has... what's his name? I think... I don't want to use names because I might fuck something up. But that show recently that they had that one girl on from Fire... Not Fire. Blaze. And like they were making fun of her. I forget the situation, but... Situations like that is exactly what I'm talking about. If you make a response video like Sargon of Akkad did, you will get hit by a copyright strike. Fake! Entirely fake, because it falls completely under fair use law. But you'll still be hit, and it's scary. And for a smaller creator, it's really scary. Because you have to sign your name and say, I will fucking go to court with you if I must. But that's what we have to do if we know we're in the right. And I don't break fair use law. I know fair use law to some degree. I'm no lawyer, but I know the I know a good bit about it. I know when I'm out of line and when I'm not. And even if I didn't, I'd look it up as soon as possible to check if I had any doubts. And many of these times, I don't. Many times, I've gotten hit by these content ID things, and I just let them stay because they are legitimate. For example, there have been many times I've had some games where I can't monetize them, and the company monetized them instead. And there's nothing I can do in that situation because it is the company. I'm playing their game. I can't really argue that. I might be able to make a fair use argument, but I don't see why I would. I'm playing their game. It's kind of a slippery slope there. But this is, that's why personally I believe automation needs to stop. It's very dangerous. We are in a situation now where you can literally lose your channel overnight on YouTube, and it needs to be fixed. There needs to be way more human involvement. There needs to be actual interaction. There needs to be communication on both sides. It can't just be boom, 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 boom. Your videos are dead. You're dead. You're dead. I don't like you. You're dead. We can't do that, because when we do that, it very, very, very much looks like censorship many times. Because while you can say, okay, it was a legitimate case, in the many cases that it's not, say the fair use cases, the legitimate fair use cases that tend to get very big, and sometimes many of them don't. That's the problem. For example, mine didn't. But that was a different situation. That wasn't copyright, but you get my point. Many situations where things like this happen, where our channels get hit, when stuff like that happens, many times we don't have some hero to save us. We don't have some hero to come down and just protect us. We don't. Many of these times we have to protect ourselves. So if we continue to do this, there's going to continue to be a culture of fear around smaller channels. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't scared for this channel. Frankly, it's which is exactly why I said a little bit earlier, I was a little bit freaked out when I heard Bering went down. I thought it was a legitimate case of censorship. I thought, frankly, I might have to do something. And with the state of YouTube, it's looking worse than ever before. Worse than many YouTubers have said this, and I'm kind of with them. We panic about a lot of things here on YouTube. We really do. I personally believe that we should be discussing rather than panicking. And by using clickbait titles, we completely destroy any arguments and any defenses and anything we have against YouTube. And because it just kills discussion. It makes us look very terrible by using clickbait titles. But that being said, because we've done that so often, while they were important issues, YouTube seems to have turned a blind eye to many of these things. And because of that, looking how bad the situation is really now, I'm not sure we're going to be able to recover. And that's a very, very scary thought. Many people are already going to a place called vid.me. I might make something there. I think I already did make an account. People are talking about mines. I have an account there too. I don't have any videos there, but I just have an account just in case. It's scary times. It's very scary times. Even I have noticed view dropouts, and I'm not so sure it's necessarily my fault. That's the whole problem about it, is we have people saying that some people are having subscribers just disappear when they upload videos. There's so much information out there, and it's hard to say what's real and what's fake. But judging by how people, even PewDiePie himself, essentially looked YouTube in the face and said, he's going to leave, in a way. He didn't say it directly, but he implied it. When we have the king of this site saying that, we might be in trouble. So I believe it's the time to open dialogues again. It's the time to try and go about this once again, but we need to go about it in the right way. So please, I know some of you are going to still do it, but please, for God's sakes, stop clickbaiting if you give a fuck about what you're talking about. I know you. Some of you really want money or you want attention or whatever, but guys, come on. The site could die overnight. Statistics are saying that YouTube is actually down a whole 50%, which means we're actually approaching that dead level. it's time to open these dialogues again, because I personally believe the whole reason YouTube has fallen apart is how many creators they've kicked off, how many times people are giving up, because the fact of the matter is, when we take out this many channels, sometimes, believe it or not, some fan bases only go on for even the small YouTubers. When they do this, YouTube loses people too. And I know they don't want to believe that, especially coming from someone with 193 subs. But I'm telling you right now, people won't believe me. But I believe, and I've seen it definitely with slightly bigger channels than me, if a channel is taken down many times, a good chunk of them will leave YouTube with them. So we need to think of something. We need to really do something. I'm not the man with the solutions at the moment. I just want to bring this up because it's a pretty hot topic at the moment. It's very... not many people are talking about this specific part about it. They're mainly just talking about bearing. But I wanted to bring light on this topic again, see if I could get a dialogue started. Unfortunately, at least when this video goes out, probably not right away, if ever. Because unfortunately, our channel is smaller. So we can't have much of an effect, even if I wanted to have an effect. But regardless, I feel it's important to try. So, yeah. At this point, I'm repeating myself and rambling, so I'm going to wrap up with the following. Like I said, we need to be very careful with this stuff. We need to stop overhyping a lot of this stuff. And to be fair, I did talk about YouTube here, so I guess you could say I'm a little bit of a hypocrite, but I didn't, like I said, I didn't overhype it or anything. I just talked about it. And I expressed my genuine displeasure with it. But we need to focus on where we are now, not in the past at the moment. We need to try to somehow get these people's attention, and otherwise we could be in trouble. Not just me, not just all the big guys, just like I said, even PewDiePie, even the fucking king of this site. We all could be in danger. So, keep that in mind. Anyway, this has been Xel'crin. Thank you so much for watching. And I will see you in the next video, stream, or the fuck you find me. Bye, guys.
Can't use that. destroyed.
Welcome to the future. A pity you're too late to stop it. No one can stop me now.
Blood for blood.
Xel'crin will see to it that your stay here is a short one.
Thus endure I reign supreme.
Well done. You have proven worthy to test your skills against my master engineer, Telonicus.
Anarala Ballore!
As you see, I have many weapons in my arsenal.
It's too far away! Closer. I can't carry anymore.
I underestimated you. It would be unfair to make you fight all four advisors at once, but fair treatment was never shown to my people. I'm just returning the favor.
That bag is full.